let's see how to prove this theorem. The statement goes like this: the angles opposite to two equal sides of a triangle are equal. So basically, in a triangle, when we know that two sides are equal, then the result is the two angles opposite to the equal sides are equal. This is what we have to prove. So let's take up a triangle and call it triangle ABC. So two equal sides. So let AB be equal to AC. Let the side AB be equal to the side AC. So if AB is equal to AC, the side opposite to AB is, sorry, the angle opposite to AB is angle C. The angle opposite to AB is angle C. See, this is a construction. Don't ignore this now. Just see the triangle ABC. Just see the triangle ABC in which AB is equal to AC. So the angle opposite to AB is angle C. And the angle opposite to AC is angle B. So in triangle ABC, if AB is equal to AC, we need to prove that angle C is equal to angle B. See, C is opposite to this side. B is opposite to this side. So when these two sides are equal, the angles opposite to them are also equal. That is what we have to prove. So given triangle ABC, in which AB is equal to AC, two sides are equal, we need to prove that the angles opposite to these two equal sides are also equal. That is, angle B is equal to angle C. So we have only one triangle. So we are going to take up a construction and divide this triangle into two smaller triangles. Construction, draw AD. And what is AD? It's a line segment, but it's the bisector of angle A. Draw AD, the bisector of angle A. That means AD bisects angle A or divides angle A into two equal halves. So AD is a line segment which is the bisector of angle A. And you can see AD meets BC in D. That's a construction. Now let's see how to prove this result. Proof. Mention the two triangles we are going to take up. So in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, we're going to take up these two triangles. We're going to take up these two triangles and show that they are congruent. We're going to show that these two triangles on either sides of AD are identical. They are congruent to each other. Let's see how to do that. So in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, here the way you name the triangles is not important. You can call it ABD, BAD, DAB. You can call this ACD or CAD or DAC. The order is not important here. Only when you use the is congruent to symbol, when you use the symbol is congruent to, then the order, that is the way you name the triangles, the order in which you use the letters or the vertices is very important. So in these two triangles, we'll have to mention three things. See here. Now, since we're going to prove this using the SAS congruence criterion, we need to write out the three equalities satisfying SAS. So see here, two sides included angle. Let's begin. So what do we know? We know that AB of triangle ABD is equal to AC of triangle ACD. That is, you'll have to pick one side or one angle from this triangle and say it is equal to one side or one angle respectively of the other triangle. So when you say AB of the first triangle is equal to AC of the second triangle. So this is one equality between the sides. AB is equal to AC. AB of this triangle is equal to AC of this triangle. Next, AD is equal to AD common side. This is another equality. AD is equal to AD because the line segment is equal to itself. Common side, AD is equal to AD. That is, AD of the first triangle is equal to AD of the second triangle because that's a common side. This side is common. AD is a side of this triangle. AD is also a side of this triangle. Common side. Next, since AD bisects the vertical angle A, AD bisects the vertical angle A, we know that this angle is equal to this angle. That is, angle BAD is equal to angle CAD. Because AD bisects the full angle A, so that means these two halves are equal. Angle BAD is equal to angle CAD. That's by construction. By construction, because AD bisects angle A. So BAD is equal to CAD. Now let's check if these three equalities satisfy the SAS criterion. Now the equalities mentioned here must be two sides and the included angle. Now, which are the sides we have taken up in the first triangle, AB and AD, and the angle is angle BAD. See, remember, all that we have in the LHS of the equality, the left-hand side of the equalities, we have three equalities, right? One, two, three, three equalities. The line segment or angle, the sides or angles we have mentioned in the left-hand side, this one, left-hand side of the equalities, belong to the first triangle. And whatever we have mentioned in the right-hand side of the equalities, right-hand side of the equalities, belong to the second triangle. So now let's take up all that we have in the LHS. AB, AD, angle BAD. AB, AD, angle BAD. Clearly, these two sides, AB and AD, contain this angle BAD. That is, include this angle BAD. See it? AB, AD, angle BAD. Apply it in the triangle. AB, AD, and angle BAD. So, two sides, included angle. Check the other one. AC, AD, take up all the elements in the RHS. AC, AD, and CAD. AC, AD, and CAD. So these two sides, AC and AD, these two sides. And this is the included angle. You can see that these two sides contain this angle, include this angle. See here, you can see where these two sides meet, this angle is formed. This is the included angle. So clearly the elements in the LHS and RHS satisfy the SAS criterion. That is, in the first triangle, we have taken up two sides and the included angle. In the second triangle also, we have taken up two sides and the included angle. So by the SAS congruence criterion, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. Now, this order in which we name the triangles become very important. Let's see that here. Now, just in the rough column, maybe you can just do this in the rough column. Now, we have mentioned two things. AB is equal to AC, AD is equal to AD. Now, A is common. You can see this letter A, which is common here, and this letter A, which is common here. So let me write AB as BA. Let me write AB as BA. See, I have written the same thing here. AB is equal to AC is written as BA is equal to CA. AB is written as BA. AC is written as CA. And this information, AD is equal to AD, I have written as it is. AD is equal to AD as it is. Now see here, BA, AD, BAD. CA, AD, CAD. Just make sure that the common vertex, you know, see a BA, AD, the common vertex, you BA ends with a common vertex A and you continue with AD. CAAD. So you stop with the common vertex and you pick up from there in the next one. Write AB as BA and write AC as CA. And then here we have AD is equal to AD. Let that remain AD is equal to AD. Now see it, BA, AD. So it is BA, AD or BAD. Why BA, AD? A is the same, right? So BAD, triangle BAD. Congruent to triangle CAAD, CAAD, so CAD. So triangle BAD is congruent to triangle CAD. This is the order in which we name the triangles. That means the vertex B of this triangle coincides with vertex C of this triangle. Vertex A of this triangle coincides with vertex A of this triangle. Vertex D of this triangle coincides with vertex D of this triangle. Also, side BA coincides with side CA. Side AD of this triangle coincides with side AD of this triangle. And side BD of the first triangle coincides with side CD of the second triangle. So this order is very important. Now, what you see here is ABD, ACD. That's also correct. See here, ABD, ABD, then it should be ACD. If you say ABD, the second one, ABD, you must say ACD. So that's what is mentioned here, ABD congruent to ACD. This is also fine. You can write it like this, BAD congruent to CAD. You can write this. Instead of this, you can write this. This is also correct. So ABD is congruent to ACD, or as we have written here, BAD is congruent to CAD. So this means angle B is equal to angle C, because that's what we understood. If the triangles are congruent, their corresponding angles and corresponding sides are equal, because they're congruent. The triangles are congruent. If the triangles are congruent, that means they're identical triangles. So their corresponding vertices and corresponding sides, they coincide, which means angle B coincides with angle C. That means angle B is equal to angle C. Angle B is equal to angle C. So angle B of the first triangle is equal to angle C of the second triangle. Angle B of the first triangle is equal to angle C of the second triangle. That's what we had to prove. Prove that angle B is equal to angle C. So we say angle B is equal to angle C. Once we prove that the triangles are congruent, the equalities we write out of congruency, we give the reason as CPCT. CPCT. Once we show that the two triangles are congruent, once they're congruent, we have other equalities which is not known to us. We have other equalities happening which is not known to us. So for such equalities that arise out of congruency of two triangles, the reason we give is CPCT. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are also equal. So since the two triangles are congruent, you can see it here. Angle B is equal to angle C. The second vertex here, the second vertex here. Angle B is equal to angle C. So angle B is equal to angle C, CPCT. That's what we have to prove. So which means in a triangle, when two sides are equal, the angles opposite to them are also equal. Let's take up a triangle like this here. All right. Supposing this side is equal to this side. Supposing these two sides are equal. In a triangle, when two sides are equal, supposing this side is equal to this side, the angle opposite to this side is equal to the angle opposite to this side. So when these two sides are equal, the angle opposite to this side is this angle. the angle opposite to this side is this angle. So when these two sides are equal, these two angles are also equal. That is the result we have proved here.